Hey, good evening. So here I am roughing it. So fortunately, my parents let me use their hot tub, and I'm getting to come to you right now and make a video and just share some thoughts I had from today. So you can see what we're doing here is really roughing it for the case of the gospel. And so sometimes you have to do that. But, you know, hey, one of the good things about what it is that we get to do and being at home. So just this evening, all day today, I've been thinking a lot about what it is to be a follower of Jesus, what it is to be a Christian. And honestly, I really wanted to make a video talking about God in a hot tub because I've never got to do that. So I thought that would be fun. But one thing that's really struck me, to be honest with you, is the fact that we talk about this word Christian and being a Christian. And when you look at the Bible, in most of the translations, the word Christian, that term might only be used, depending on the translation, 2 to 3 times. And really, really what it usually says is that we're in Christ. And I don't know if I know exactly what that means, Jordan. I don't know if I know exactly what that means. So praying about it, studying about it, the life of a Christian, if you will, is a life in Christ. And it had me thinking about the hot tub. See, here's what I know. I'm not a doctor. I don't know a lot about biology, but what I'm aware of is positionally right now I'm in the hot tub, meaning in relation to the hot tub. I'm not next to it. I'm not far away from it. I'm not above it or below it, but I'm in it. And when I'm in it, my skin, even though it seems solid, it's actually porous. There's pores. It absorbs this water. As I'm in the water, it absorbs it. And organically, what's happening is I'm bonding with this water. And that's one of the dangers about, you know, getting into a body of water and how it can make you sick, because your body actually organically becomes one with that water that you're in. You absorb it, and the stuff off of your skin gets into the water, and there's an intermixing. And so what the Bible is talking about is you and I in Christ, when we come to Him, when we choose Him as our Lord and Savior, we become one with Him. We actually become organically bonded. The metaphor used in the scripture is a vine in a branch, or a tree in a branch. It could be a body and an arm. You're attached. And even though it's possible to separate the two, it's not good for the arm to be detached from the body. You lose your source of life. It's not good for the branch to be detached from the vine. It'll wither up and die, or the branch from the tree. And so for you who've once been connected, become one with Christ, to take yourself out of that, it's not good for you either, or for me. So to be in Christ, what does that mean? What does that look like? Jesus talks about another thing in the Bible, and it's this idea of abiding in Him. And if we would abide in Him, and He in us, right, we would bear much fruit. Brandy and I were having a conversation about this just today. You know that word abide? It's more than a positional word. It's an obedience word, a following word. If you live continuously, of course, this is not a dictionary definition. If you would live in obedience, if you would obey and stay with what Christ is doing, if you would be so close to Him that you are one, and if you are going where He's going and doing what He's doing, then your life would be full of fruit. It's like the scripture says, if you want life, then you have to be attached to the source of life. And the only place is God. It's Jesus. It's the Holy Spirit that's with you. And so Jesus said things like, if you want your life, you give it up. And what does that even mean? What do I have to give up? Everything is the answer. I give up everything, and whatever he gives me back will be full of life. If you hold on to it, if you protect, persevere, it's not going to be life. It's going to be less than what it could be. And honestly, I don't think I'm doing that like I should. I don't think we're doing that. I see what we do ends up becoming religion. It's fear-based, and it's God, like, I don't know if you're going to take care of this, so I want to do your thing and my thing blended together. And it just doesn't work. It's maddening. It's driving me crazy, honestly, at times. And I want more than that. I want life. And the only way for me to do that is to give my life up. So if I really want to be in Christ, I've got to be willing to give my life up and be a new creation, as it says in Ephesians. So maybe now that certain things are being taken away from us, for how long, I don't know. Maybe we need to go farther than that. Maybe what you're asking us to do, God, is to just give you more of our life. It's like Brandy was sharing with me. What's the first thing you can do? The very first thing you can do, most important, is to praise God, to rejoice, worship God, because it's what you were made to do. And then when you do that, you know he's worthy to be obeyed, worthy to be followed. So then we follow him. And then we get hope and joy and peace and life. But instead, what we try to get is life and hope and peace and joy. It's backwards. It's backwards. We're striving. And when God wants to show us grace, which is unforced, he wants to show us, be in me, like this hot tub, become one with me. Wherever I go, go with me. Wherever you go, know I'm with you, and it's no longer your life, but mine. God, make us open our eyes, make us hit our knees to the ground and bring our heads low to worship you, to know that you're greater and higher and we're less. In the mercy, in the patience, in the grace in which you use to love us, we don't deserve all the things you've done for me, yet I still hold on to the things I want. Forgive us, God, forgive us. Fill me with your spirit and teach me to be in you. Well, God bless you guys and have a good evening. Yes, I